Hey, Mike Redding here from usingtechnologybetter.com. Just wanted to make a real quick video to show you two new features that have just been released inside Google that we've been asking for quite a while. And so the first one that I'm really excited about is this option here to shuffle the question order. Now, if we want to have two students sitting next to each other, but they see different questions at different times, all we need to do is just tick this box, and then those questions will just be shuffled for us. Now, we've had for a little while the option underneath our multiple choice questions to click on advanced settings and shuffle the option order around the answers, but now we can actually shuffle the question order, which is great. The only downside to this at the moment is that if you tick this box here and your first question is what is your name, then that question will also get shuffled, and so different students might find that in different places, which could be a little bit confusing. So hopefully one of the next updates that will come will be the ability to freeze certain questions or to be able to select the questions that we want to have shuffled. The next option that has just been released as well is this option here to only allow one response per person. So this will be a great feature. The one thing to be aware of here that is if you give your students the link, they need to be signed into Google Apps to make that happen. Now, they don't need to be signed in with the Google Apps account that they have at the school. They do, however, need to be signed in with some sort of a Google Apps account. So, for instance, if I open up Safari here and drop it in without being signed into a Google account, then it's going to ask me to sign in first. So this will work with any Google account, but just be aware that there are some limitations. The other option that was just been released is inside Google Presentations, where we can now go into our formatting option here and click on Image Options, which now gives us the ability to change the transparency of our images. So this is a great feature. Once again, been asking for this for quite some time. So now what you can do is you can put your text in and then overlay your images and have that transparency. You can also see here that you can adjust your brightness and your contrast, and you can also have a look at some of these recolor options, which will change obviously the color of it. If you'd like to receive other tips and tricks on how you can use technology better, then head over to usingtechnologybetter.com. If you have any questions, then simply leave a comment in the comment section below this video, and we'll make sure that we continue the conversation there. We'll see you in the next video.